heading of document splitting. Put the heading of document splitting. You write the notes. Before going to write the notes, you people understand one thing. When you post any document entry in the SAP, document entry means accounting entry. When you post any document entry in the SAP, document entry segregate two types. One is header data, one is line item data. Everyone, you just catch the point. Document entry means accounting entry segregate or classified two types. One is header data, one is line item data. Okay, for example, let's watch this. I will show you. Example, give me 1 minute. Going on browse. See this one. Example, see this one. When I want to post GL accounting entry, let's see. FB50, enter. How to enter GL accounting entry? Which parameters required? I will tell you later. Now, what you need to understand, when you want to post any accounting entry in the SAP, it's classified two datas. One is header data, one is line item data. See here, whatever information you entered into these fields, that is called header data. What is meant by that fields? I mean, what you need to enter that fields, I will tell you later. At the time of accounting entry, I will tell you. But now you need to understand what is meant by header data, what is meant by line item data. Whatever information you entered into these fields, that information is called header data. Whatever information you entered into these fields, this information is called line item data. Line item. Okay. For example, do one thing. Go to FB60. See here, what is this? Enter vendor invoice. This is vendor invoice posting. Whatever information you are entering to these fields, okay, this is called header data. Whatever information you can post in these fields, that is called line item data. Example, do one thing and go to a slash n FB70, enter. Same thing, see this one, enter customer invoice. Whatever information you can enter to this field, that is called header data. Whatever information you can post to these fields, that is called line item data. Very simple. You just catch the point. When the accounting entry classified into two datas. One is header data, one is classified data. Now my question is, what is meant by document splitting? What is meant by document splitting? Document splitting means to split line item. To split a line item. Example, let it be. For example, let's see. Already we discussed it in the first class of new GL. For example, When I post in the normal accounting entry, this is the way accounting entry will be generated. Rent account data to cash and amount equal to amount. But when you do the new GL, especially in the document splitting, when you do the document splitting, how the accounting entry will be generated? See this one, GL account data to GL, amount equal to amount, business area to business area, profit center to profit center, segment to segment. So this type of parameters is classified to classify the line item. Okay, even when your parameters not equal, business debit business area and credit business area not equal, and I mean profit center, debit profit center and credit credit side profit center is not equal, in if debit side segment and credit side segment is not equal, what happened? That time zero balance clearing account will be involved. Rent account data to zero balance clearing account, zero balance clearing account data to cash. Why the zero balance clearing account will be involved? If debit side parameters not equal to credit side parameters, that time zero balance clearing account will be involved. Very, very, very simple. Why you are doing the document splitting? You are doing the document splitting for classify the line item. What is meant by line item? Line item, it is at the time of accounting entry. Okay, at the time of accounting entry, there is an line item. We want to do the document splitting for split the line item. Everyone, any doubts? Anyone? Rajkumar, are you there? John?
Yes, Venkat.
Yeah, I'm following, sir.
Yeah, note it down, John.
Okay.
Yes, Rajkumar, please note it. If you post any document entry, note it down. If you post any document entry, note it down. Notes. If you post any document entry, document entry means accounting entry. Okay, in the bracket you put as a accounting entry. Don't confuse. Okay, comma. Document entry classified two datas. Document entry classified two datas. One is header data and line item data. Header data and line item data. Write the next line. Document splitting. Document splitting configuration for line item splitting. Why you are doing document splitting? For line item splitting, we need to do line item splitting. See here, this is the classic GL and this is the new GL. We want to split amount and we want to split business area, we want to split profit center, we want to split segment. Like we are splitting the reports. I have need required for segment reporting, profit center reporting, business area reporting, GLs reporting. Every accounting entry split the reports. That is the reason we want to do document splitting. Okay, very simple. What you write? Document splitting configuration for split line item. Everyone, did you write? Renuka?
Yes, Venkat.
Completed?
Done, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, note it down. Next line. Document splitting is a tool. Document splitting is a tool. Provided in SAP, provided in SAP New GL, provided in SAP New GL. Okay. For determine for determine determine the missing account assignments missing account assignments for determine the missing account assignments in various process in various process in the bracket like you can put vendor invoice, customer invoice, which process, vendor invoice, customer invoice, like that. Do one thing, you people understand one thing actually. Everyone, look into this. Done? Basically, one second. See this one. Document splittings. How many types of document splittings in SAP? How many types of document splittings in SAP? See this one. Everyone, you just concentrate here. One is active splittings and passive splittings and zero balance splitting. See this one, everyone, you just catch the point. How many types of document splittings available in SAP? Very, very important. very, very important. The interviewer asks the question, what is meant by document splitting? That time you want to say document splitting is required for class, to split the line item. How many it is types of document splitting: active splitting, passive splitting, and zero balance splitting. Okay, how many types of document splittings? Active splitting, passive splitting, and zero balance splitting. What is meant by active splitting? And what is meant by passive splitting? And what is meant by zero balance splitting? Listen carefully. Active splitting means to split line item. Active splitting means to split a line item. Same as document splitting, I gave notes. And what is meant by passive splitting? What is meant by passive splitting? This one you just catch the point. What is meant by passive splitting? Example, when I post, or if I post invoice accounting entry, example, vendor invoice or customer invoice, whatever invoice, if I post invoice accounting entry, at the time of invoice accounting entry, I specified business area and profit center and segment, right? And the against of invoice accounting entry, I will post payment, right? First, I can post invoice accounting entry. It may be vendor or it may be customer. Against of this invoice accounting entry, I will post payment accounting entry. Accounts entry. You just catch the point here. Passive splitting means this payment document entry or payment accounts entry split based on invoice entry. Everyone catch the point here. What is meant by passive splitting means this payment document entry or payment accounting entry split based on invoice accounting entry. Okay, this active splitting depending on your standard configuration. This payment accounting entry depending on invoice accounting entry. It means whatever parameter specified into invoice accounting entry at the time of invoice posting, same parameters automatically picks at the time of payment accounting entry. Once again, I will repeat, catch the point. Passive splitting means at the time of payment accounting entry, it is depending on invoice accounting entry. Whatever parameters means business area, profit center, segment, whatever parameters you specified at the time of invoice posting, all the parameters automatically reflected at the time of payment accounting entry or document entry. Automatically reflected this payment accounting entry depending on invoice accounting entry. Accounting entry means document entry. Okay, and what is meant by zero balance splitting? What is meant by zero balance splitting? We already discussed zero balance splitting means when the debit side parameters not equal to credit side parameters, that time zero balance clearing account will be involved. Anyone, any doubts here?
Sir, give me some examples, accounts, passive splitting, sir, so that we can understand.
That's what passive splitting means. This is the example. If I post any vendor invoice, If you post any customer invoice, okay, this payment, customer payment or just, vendor payment.
Just give me how to post the. How to post the? It means like debit and credit entry.
How
just
to post means I will tell you later, Harish. How to post?
Sir, I am asking. Just show me the what is the debit entry? What should be the creditor? So that we can understand better. Understand.
Example, this is the Harish. This is debit entry and this is credit entry. Example, let it okay. be. Example.
See, let Harish. When we are processing in AP side entry, invoice processing team will be there, right?
Yeah.
They are processing the invoices, okay?
Yeah.
But there is a due date, like 30 days, 45 days, 60 days, 90 days is the payment terms.
Yeah.
According to the payment terms, the payment team will, the payment entry automatically pick based on the due date.
Okay. Before making
so that
the
time,
payment,
yes, sir. So that time there is no entry recorded because the entry already recorded in invoice processing team. Am I correct, okay. sir?
No. Here I will add one thing. The invoice team specified business area and profit center and segment. The Naveen is posting invoice. Harish is posting payment. Okay. At the time of Naveen posting, invoice posting, he specified business area, profit center, and segment. So based on the due date, I will tell you later. Based on due date, Harish is posting the payment accounting entry. So at the time of payment accounting entry, not required to specify business area, profit center, and segment. These three things picks automatically. That is what I am explaining here. Okay. This payment accounting entry depending on invoice accounting entry. Why you are doing the payment? This is against of invoice. Are you catch my point? Why you are... double istava. We are not giving
sir.
Any amount is free of cost, right? When you give the invoice.
So what I am? Okay. But tell suppose me. I will post a one entry every 60. Three debit items should be 3,000. I will give three purchases account debit side. One in credit side, only one vendor I will give. At the time of document splitting activation, it should become one debit should be purchase account, one more is credit, that is vendor account. It is like that only, sir?
Same thing, yes, correct.
Okay.
Yeah. Got it, my point? Everyone, any doubts? You people draw this one. Everyone, fast. You can write the fast.
Okay.
John?
Yeah.
Yeluka, Rajkumar, any doubts? No doubt, right?
No, I have no doubts.
Okay. Very good, Naveen. Very good. Write it fast. Done.
market.
Yeah, I can go for configuration, document splitting configuration. So this is the required for document splitting configuration. Okay, see this one. The first one is classify GL accounts for document splitting. Classify GL accounts for document splitting. What is meant by classify GL account for document splitting? When I go to chart of account configuration, listen careful. When I go to chart of account configuration, go up. So this is the accounts group, right? This is the accounts group I defined. Please remember, this is the accounts group I defined. Like example, capital, reserves and surplus, sundry debitor and sundry creditor, blah blah blah, XYZ. What is meant by classified? What is meant by classified? Classified means which accounts group comes under profit and loss account, which accounts group comes under balance sheet, which accounts group is an asset, which accounts group is an like liability, which accounts group expenses, which accounts group revenue. We need to classify that. Everyone, you just catch the point? You are the very well, very good people. You will understand. Oh, okay. This fixed asset means, where is that? Okay. This current asset, and where is fixed asset? Yeah. Fine. This fixed asset means this is an asset. You know very well. And this example, this direct expenses means it is an expenses. You know very well. But how the system will understand? How the system will understand? When the system want to understand, you need to classify this accounts group. Got it my point? We are segregating this accounts group into like which accounts groups comes under balance sheet, which accounts groups comes under profit and loss account, like expenses, incomes, like that. We need to classified this accounts group. Where we created this accounts group in SAP, go to SAP and the T code slash and go back, enter here OBD4, enter. And click on your position. What is our chart of accounts?
GMOC, sir.
Very good. GMOC. Very good. And see this one. Here I created accounts group. Here I created accounts group. And like last classes, some global parameters. So this accounts groups comes under and which statement? Is this expenses? Is this income? Is this asset? Is this liability? How the system will understand? Because of classification. Because of classification. When you do the classification, system will understand, okay, this is the expenses, this is the income, this is comes under balance sheet, this is comes under like income statement, like that. Okay, yeah. And see how to classify the GL account for document splitting. SPRO, financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, business transaction, document splitting, classify GL account for document splitting. Anji, are you there?
Yes.
Are you understand?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, how to classify GL accounts? SPRO, financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, business transaction, document splitting, classify GL account for document splitting. Very simple. Go to SAP, listen careful. Slash N, go back. Go on mute, please. SPRO, enter. Sorry, SAP reference IMG, and select here financial accounting new, and general ledger accounting. And business transaction and document splitting. The first one, classify GL account for document splitting. Very simple. Financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, business transaction and document splitting. First one, classify GL account for document splitting. You just double click on here. And enter here your chart of accounts. What is your chart of accounts?
GMOC.
OC, very good. GMOC. And click on here. Okay. Yeah. This is chart of accounts, and click on here new entry. Click on here new entry, and this is from and to. What is mean by from and to? Go to Excel and see here. This is the from number to to number. This is from number to to number. Example, this capital from number to to number, capital from number to to number. And this capital belongs to which statement? And click on this category. This is the capital number category you need to select. See here, there is an, a different categories. See this one, balance sheet, asset, expenses, revenues, like taxes, vendors, customer, lot of things is available. Example, this capital comes under balance sheet. Press enter. We are segregating. Okay. And see here. And even this reserves and surplus, secured loans, unsecured loans, and both are comes under balance sheet. We are segregating. Press enter. So this meeting will end within 1 minute. You please join again, everyone. Okay. See here and go to SAP. The system will understand this is comes under balance sheet. And see here, this one is completed, right? I will change the color for your understanding. And sundry creditor. This sundry creditor means it is a vendor. It comes under vendor. Why I am copy pasting from Excel? Same way I maintained into the SAP OBD4 T code OB accounts group. I maintained same way in the SAP. That is the reason I am copy pasting. And comes under tax payable. What is meant by tax payable? This is also completed and comes under tax payable. You take the tax payable, control C. This is comes under taxation. Where is taxation? Here, tax on sales and purchases. Then press enter. And this one also completed. And current liabilities. And current liabilities also comes under balance sheet. Press enter. Okay, and this one also done. And asset, this is the fixed asset. select this, comes under fixed asset. Fixed asset or asset, whatever. Yeah, I even see this one, inventory is an asset, cash on bank an asset, and sundry debitors also asset. These three things comes under asset. What is that? Inventory and cash and bank comes under asset. We are segregating which is an asset, which is an balance sheet, which is an asset means comes under balance sheet, expenses means profit and loss account, like that. Okay, press enter. And this is the completed. Now I want to do sundry debitor. Sundry debitor means customer. Debitor means customer. And go down. Customer also done. Then tax payable. Tax payable comes under tax on sales and purchases. Comes under tax on sales and purchases. We are segregating the accounts group, which is comes under and what which statement. Example, see this one, this current asset and miscellaneous expenses write off comes under asset. And this one also done. See everyone, this sales revenue, sales, other incomes, and increasing, decreasing stock, all are incomes or revenues. This is comes under revenues. Where is revenue? Yeah, this is the revenue. Press enter and go back. So this one also done. And see here, raw material consumption, personal expenses, direct expenses, and other sales and distribution expenses, indirect expenses, all are comes under yes, very good, expenses. Who said? This is comes under expenses. Press enter and save. Save. So this one example, this is comes under balance sheet, this is vendor, this is asset, this is asset. The system will understand whatever GLs comes create this accounts group, this is belongs to this statement, this is asset, this is expenses, this is income. System will understand. That is the reason we are segregating, we are classifying. Okay, anyone any doubts? No doubt, right? Yeah. The next step. So this one is done. The next one. Classify document type for document splitting. Actually, we have a lengthy topic in the document type. Actually, we have very lengthy topic into document type. Here I will give you introduction, later I will give you more examples and more explanation what is mean by document type. For example, do one thing. Document type means classify the accounting entry or classify the document entry. For example, whatever accounting entry have SA document type, that is called GL accounting entry. Whatever document type, sorry, whatever document entry or accounting entry, whatever accounting entry have SA document type, that is called GL accounting entry or GL document entry. And whatever, accounting entry or document entry have KR document type, that is called vendor invoice posting. Example, whatever accounting entry or document entry have DR document type, that is called customer invoice. Example, this is GL and this is vendor and this is customer. What happened here? This document types classified the accounting entries or document entries. Okay, got it my points? We have very lengthy session regarding to this document type. Now you can understand basic information. Okay, what is meant by document type? Document type means classify the document entry or classify the accounting entry. Okay, and see, specify document type for document splitting. Specify document type for document splitting. We need to specify it, which is comes under debit, which is comes like, which is comes under customer, which is comes under like, you know, a vendor, which is standard, like that. We need to specify that. So how to do in the SAP, I will tell you. SPRO, financial accounting new, and general ledger accounting new, business transaction, document splitting, classify document type for document splitting. Classify document type for document splitting. Classify document splitting for SPRO, enter. SAP reference IMG. Select here financial accounting new and general ledger accounting new and business transaction, document splitting, and see here, see this one, classify document type for document splitting. Example, see here, let's take SA document type, SA, and transactional variant. Let's example, 0000 is unspecified posting, like 0001 is standard. You need to select here at the time of document splitting. I will tell you later. SA means GL document, and click on your position. KR, what is mean by KR? Vendor invoice posting. Vendor invoice posting. So what is mean by this 0300? What is mean by 0300? Means we are specifying vendor invoice. We are specifying. What is mean by specifying? This KR comes under vendor invoice. This KR means vendor invoice. We are specifying. And click on your position. And DR, see this one, where is DR? This DR, customer invoice, you know, DR means customer invoice. We are directing to the system. We are giving instruction to the system. Okay, DR means customer invoice. You need to select here customer invoice. Customer invoice. Okay, already standard is there. Don't change anything. Okay, for your understanding purpose, once again I'm explaining. Example, for example, AA, what is meant by AA? For example, asset accounting posting, unspecified posting and standard. Sometimes we need to specify unspecified. See this one, customer, vendor, bank transaction, and payments, clearing. If it is not there, straight away you can select unspecified. Asset is not there, right? If it is not there in the classification, you can select unspecification. already all the document types classified. Don't change anything. Okay, you can just watch it is correct or not. Very simple. Okay, example KZ, example KZ. What is mean by KZ? KZ means vendor payment. KZ means vendor payment. What is mean by 1000 transactional? It is an payment. See this one. Where is that? This one. Payment. This is the payment. Vendor payment means payment. We are classifying the document type. Okay. Click already. This is the standards. It will come. Don't change anything. For your understanding, I will say. Save and back. And later define zero balance clearing account. What is mean by zero balance clearing account? Anyone, any doubt for classified document type for document splitting?
No, Venkat.
No doubt. Okay, very good, thank you. And even later I will explain you more information regarding document type. Okay, and define zero balance clearing account. And what is meant by zero balance clearing account? See here, whenever debit side parameters and credit side parameters not equal, that time zero balance clearing account will be involved. So when the zero balance account will be involved, if zero balance account will be involved, first you can create this zero balance clearing account. Later you can assign into define zero balance clearing account. Okay, one second. So this one is completed. The next one, define zero balance clearing account. This is the one. Define zero balance clearing account. Why I want to do this step means if debit side parameters not equal to credit side parameters. Excuse me, go on mute please. If debit side parameters not equal to credit side parameters, that time zero balance clearing account will be involved. So that is the reason you want to do this step. If you want to assign zero balance clearing account, first you need to create GL account. Which GL account? Zero balance clearing account. This zero balance clearing account comes under current liability. This zero balance clearing account comes under current liability. And this current liability, what is the number range? See here I can create current liability, right? Current liability 1600002169999, current liability. This is the current liability. Under this current liability, I want to create zero balance clearing account. Okay, and see this one. First, when you want to define this zero balance clearing account, first you need to create GL account. First you need to create GL account. Later you can do that step. Okay, how to create the GL account? See this one. Go to FS00. Actually, regarding to this GL account, we have very big topic into coming classes, GL master data. In the GL master data, we have very, very, very lengthy topics, how to create the GLs. Okay, at that time I will give more and more information. First, now you need to understand like a zero balance clearing account. How to create the GLs, what is meant by that, what is meant by this. At the time of GL master data creation, I will give you more information. Okay, just you can understand now how to create the zero balance clearing account and how to assign this. When you want to do this step, first you need to create the GL, zero balance clearing account GL. Later you want to do this step. Okay, that zero balance clearing account comes under current liability. Okay, and how to create GL, how to create the GL, T code is FS00 and here 16000, and what is your company code? GM10, right? GM10. Then click on here create. And what is accounts group? Accounts group is current liability. If current liability comes under balance sheet, and click on this like zero balance. Clearing account, zero balance clearing account, and click on your control data. Okay, and line item display. See what is meant by account currency, what is meant by only balance in local currency, what is meant by these fields. Every field I will explain you later. When I will explain, at the time of here GL master data creation, every field I will explain you. Okay, no problem. Here very simple, click on your only balance in local currency, line item display, short key 001. Every field I will explain you. First you can understand how to create, that's it. And create bank interest tab, enter here 001 and click on your post automatically. Why I want to click this post automatically? It means whenever if you not equal debit side parameters and credit side parameters, this zero balance clearing account will picks automatically. Okay, then press enter and save. Very simple. See this one, this number picks from the accounts group, this number picks from the accounts group. This is the company code. This zero balance clearing account comes under current liability. This current liability is regarding to balance sheet. And this is the description. Control data, only balance in local currency means this, this zero balance clearing account reflected only local currency. And line item display, short key 001. Create bank interest tab, 001, post automatically. Then click on your save. Okay, go back. Now you can do this step. What is this? Define zero balance clearing account. First you can create the GL. GL creation is complete. Now you can go to this path. SPRO, financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, business transaction, document splitting, define zero balance clearing account. SPRO, enter, SAP reference IMG, select here financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new. What is this? Business transaction and document splitting. This one is completed. This one, define zero balance clearing account. Double click on this and select here 000 standard one. See this one, standard account for zero balance. You just select this. Double click on accounts. What is your chart of accounts? GMOC. Yeah. Okay, yes, very good, John. Click on your GMOC. Click on your new entry. Which GL you created for zero balance clearing account? 16000. Yes. Press enter and save. press enter and save. Then go back. Once again, you can watch how to assign the 160000. Very simple. Double click on this radio button and select here 0001 and double click on accounts and enter here your chart of accounts GM OC. Press enter. See here. Here you need to assign. Click on your new entry. Assigned here 160000. Zero balance clearing account. Then click on your save and back. The next one, define document splitting characteristic for general ledger accounting. Define document splitting characteristics for general ledger accounting. Same path. Next one, define document splitting characteristic for general ledger accounting. You just double click on this. See here how the accounting entry will be generated, which parameters you can use here, business area, profit center and segment. Yes, see here same thing here also, business area, profit center, segment. If these things is available, don't do anything, straight away click on here save. If these things is not available, click on your new entry, select here business area, profit center and segment. Okay, click on your save and back. This is the functional name and this is the technical name. Functional consultant will understand functional name, and technical consultant who ABAPR will understand this type of names. Okay, and click on save and back. The last two steps, define document splitting characteristic for controlling. Okay, in the controlling which steps will come, even in depth I will explain you at the time of controlling. Now you can understand. Same path, define document splitting for characteristic for controlling. Double click on this. See here, like this document splitting regarding to sales order, cost center, cost objective, and whichever required from the CO you can select. You keep as a standard, don't change anything. Okay, keep standard. At the time of CO you can understand. Okay, like sales order, cost center, cost objective and profitability segment number, like that. Okay, just click on your save and back. The last one, activate document splitting. Okay, the last step, activate document splitting. You just double click on this. When you want to activate, just activate radio button. See here, when you click on this radio button, this is means activate. When you remove this radio button means unactivate or deactivate. When you want to deactivate, remove this document splitting radio button. When you want to activate, simply click on this. This is standard method, standard one, SAP suggestion method. Click on your save and back. Activate means you click on this radio button. Okay, do one thing. Once again you can understand this. What is meant by first step? I will give you overview, you people understand here. Classify GL account for document splitting means what? We need to classify accounts group, which is comes under balance sheet, which is comes under profit and loss account. And classify, everyone are able to hear? John?
Yes, sir.
Dhiraj, are able to understand?
Yes, I understand.
Yeah. The next step, I will give you overview. Next step, classify document type for document splitting means we have the some standard document type is there, like SA, KR and DR and different document types is there. The document types classified the accounting entries. First step is classified the accounts or accounts group. The next step is classified the accounting entries. Like which accounting entry is specified, which document type. Example, SA, GL account, and KR, vendor invoice posting, DR, customer invoice posting. At the time of, number range and document type, I will give you more information. Okay. And zero balance splitting. What is meant by zero balance splitting? If debit side parameters not equal to credit side parameters, that time you want to do this step. When you want to do this step, first you need to create the GL account. Later you can define zero balance clearing account. First you can create 160000 comes under current liability. Later you need to assign here. Okay, then define document splitting characteristic for general ledger accounting. Means there we need to specify like business area, profit center and segment. Means whenever you do the document splitting, which parameters will come, you need to do this step. Okay, and later you need to split from the characteristics for controlling, which characteristic regarding to controlling, like cost objectives, like cost, sales orders, which is comes under controlling. There is a standard one, you can select standard one. The last one you need to activate whatever steps in this up to here, that steps you need to activate in the last one. Okay, whatever configuration you did in the above steps, that steps activate in the last one. Okay, just click on this radio button. Anyone, any doubt, full-fledged, when you are understanding this configuration, means when you post one accounting entry, that time you will understand why we are doing this configuration. Okay, in full-fledged understanding, when you post one accounting entry, later we will post accounting entries. So this information picked or not, that time we will full-fledged understanding. So now you can understand configuration. Everyone, any doubts? Anyone, any doubts here?